हेलो फ्रेंड, टुडे वी आर गोइंग फॉर द लेक्चर 6। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू यूज़ आर डिफरेंट टूल्स, स्पेशली द मूव टूल एंड कट टूल्स आल्सो। हियर वी आर गोइंग टू मेड द सेम ज्योमेट्री। तो व्हाट इज दिस ज्योमेट्री? एक्चुअली दिस इज अ ज्योमेट्री फॉर द टेस्टिंग ऑफ टॉर्सन। ओके, to getting the shear modulus, how we are getting it. First I will made it, then I will show you how we are making it. So we are going to the space claim. So one by one, this is the first geometry we are going to make, that is 20 mm diameter and 800 mm of length. Okay, so we are going in the space claim. First we are selecting the XY plane. This is the grid. Click on the grid. Then we are going on the circle. We are selecting a circle of having the diameter 20 mm. Just put the dimensions, click on this convert to solid, then it will be convert to the surface. We have click on the surface, pull tool came, press the space bar, then we are putting the 800 mm. So it has came 800 mm. Our first geometry is prepared. Now in the solid, on the left hand side in the structure tree, we are going to move to a new component. We are giving the name small soft. Enter. Now what we are going to do, we have to make a new hollow soft here. So click it here, go in the design, go in the sketch mode, click it, plane view, it came. For that we need a diameter of 40 mm. So click on the center, it will become, click type the 40, press enter. After pressing the enter, we have to again go into the sketch mode, from the sketch mode to the 3D mode. From the 3D mode we came here. Then what is there actually here, what is the thing is there, we have to create 80 mm of this length on 40 mm on both sides. Okay, so what I am doing, I am clicking it here, I am clicking here, pull on both sides. Now the arrow has came here for both sides. I am pressing the space bar, I am putting 80 mm. Now you can see it has came on the both sides for 80 mm. Here I am clicking it here, I am saying move to new component, I am going sleeve, I am putting the sleeve, or I put the second shaft here. When I am putting it here, you can see that it is the solid shaft. If I don't move the small shaft into a new component, it will combine itself. Okay, I want to make it separate, that's why I have moved it to the another component. Okay, now I want the hollow here of the same dimension of the shaft. So what I am going to do, I am going to use the combine tool. Come here on the combine tool, click on the combine tool. Its name is combine, but it can tear also. Okay, so what see here in the status bar, click our target object. I am clicking on the target object. Click to select a cutter object, status bar, this is a cutter object. Now you can see in the sleeves we got the two solid, this solid which is here inside it, okay, and the top which is the outer one. So we want to remove this, just click it here, it will be removed itself. Okay, that's a benefit. Now if you want to see here, it has cut of the same dimensions. Okay, now what we have to go and to do, first we are going in the XY plane, YZ plane. In the YZ plane, I am saying sketch. I have clicked here, I am saying I want to sketch it here. Okay. Okay, it has clicked at the center. So that's a very good thing. YZ plane it is there. So at the here, from 20 mm from here, I have to make another shaft which is, we are going to use it for the rotation. So here press the shift. After pressing the shift, when you will move the cursor, it will show the dimension. It will showing the dimension the away from the axis that we don't want. We want it on the axis, then press the tab. That is on the axis how far from the vertical line. So that I want the 20 mm. From 20 mm, I want a circle of 10 mm. ठीक है, I put the circle of 10 mm. Here I am going and saying 3D. When I gone in 3D, here you can see, you cannot see that surface, but that surface is available. Here you can see the surface is available there. And what I am going to say on this surface, I want to pull on the both side. And how much I want to pull it? I want to pull it to 400 mm. Okay, so this is a 400 mm. So that you can see ZX plane, and 400 mm is there. Then again you can move to new component. I am saying torque shaft. Okay, when I am going and when I am removing this torque shaft, you can see that this is still solid. So I don't want it solid, I wanted the hollow. I want to make it the place where this shaft is going, that it should not be solid. So what I am again going design, I am saying combine tool, I am saying that this is my target body, this is my cutter object, and this the remaining part. The remaining part is this one. The remaining part should be removed out. So you can see torque shaft, when you will remove that, it is hollow is there. So that is a torque shaft. So what actually we are going to see, what we are actually here going to do here, we are going to put the strain gauge here, okay, and we will support this shaft with the bearings, and we will apply the torque with the help of the ropes. With the help of ropes, one ropes will we will tie it here, one ropes there, then we will form the torque. Due to this torque, this shaft will move. Here the strain gauges will be placed, and we are going to take the reading of that strain gauges to find the shear stresses. Okay, so for going that side, first thing I want to say, this shaft and this shaft are having the relative motion. Why do they have the relative motion? Because that is in between the that the hollow hole is there and that shaft is gone there. So first thing what we have to do, we have to put some screw or something here. For making that screw, I am again going in the sketch mode. I am came here and I don't want to just put it there. I don't want to go up to the end, so I'm not going like this. Just click it here, press it here, fire and sketch. Okay, when you have click here, then it has not gone on the cross section, that is on the top surface itself. Okay, that has just changed the dimension, changed the view itself. That's not a big deal. So I'm again going the circle here. Here you can click here the shift, you from here you can go around 10 mm, minus 10, because that is going in the negative direction. Here 10, you can create of 4 mm of screw dimension here. Okay, you can create it here 4 mm of screw dimension here. From here the 4, you can use the cut tool, you can use this cut tool up to where you can cut it. This is having the 20 mm. Okay, yes, these are having the 40 mm, and this shaft is having the 20 mm, that is the diameter. So this will be of 10 mm, the gap between of this is of 10 mm. Okay, we have drawn this. Now we want to cut it, so press it here. We want to up to where we want to cut it here. So you can see that it can cut it up to there. Okay, that's the here we will put the screw there. Okay, so again I am going, and again I am going to tell you what we are going to do here. This is the shaft.
हेयर दिस इज द शाफ्ट, हेयर द स्लीव ऑन विच इट इज कनेक्टेड. तो दिस शाफ्ट वी आर गोइंग टू अप्लाई द टॉर्क विद द हेल्प ऑफ द रोप्स. दिस शाफ्ट विल मूव, वी विल अप्लाई द स्ट्रेन गेजेस हेयर टू मेजर द. बट हाउ वी विल सपोर्ट दिस शाफ्ट, द क्वेश्चन अराइजेस. सो वी हैव टू गो एंड सी द डायमेंशन ऑफ द डायमेंशन ऑफ द बियरिंग्स विच आर अवेलेबल टू सपोर्ट दिस शाफ्ट. सो हेयर आई एम गोइंग हेयर, सो यू कैन सी हाउ वी हैव डिसाइडेड द इनर डायमीटर. एक्चुअली हेयर यू कैन सी दिस इज द एस के एफ साइड. फ्रॉम हेयर यू कैन सी द डायमीटर इज इक्वल टू 20 mm, इनर डायमीटर 20 mm, आउटर डायमीटर 40 mm, 42 mm, देन द ब्रेथ इज 12 mm इज अवेलेबल. According to our load bearing capacity, we are going to select this bearing. So here it is also of 20 diameter 47, but the width is the high according to our choice. So here you can note down these dimensions, because I am going to use these dimensions for making the making my bearings. So I'm not going to make the bearings, because the bearings options are come there, but I'm going to support system which we are going to use it there. So we know this is the shaft. We are going display it here. We are saying that display it here. We are going. So what will be happen? This will be go inside the bearings. So the outer circle of the bearing will be how much? The outer circle of the bearing will be 42 mm. To support this 42 mm, we need the another. We are again going and we are making a one housing of 42 and 5 mm. 42 and 50 mm, 5 centimeter. Okay, you can make of 5 centimeter. Or okay, I am making of 100 mm. This is just arbitrary, but you can make, but we have to calculate it of how we are going to decide this one. Okay, this is of this is, we have not taken any dimension, just I'm making it. The other dimensions we can like this trim away tools. This is trim away. This part is going to be trim away, and I'm saying here the solid. So we don't want it the inner, because that will be work as a bearing. We have to put the bearings here. So I don't want it. I'm saying the delete. Here this is the supporting housing. This supporting housing, that that is the one thing, because this is a two. Okay, here I am giving it the thickness of 10 mm. Okay, 10 mm. Okay, but that has gone outside, so that is not a big deal. So what I am going to do first, I am selecting this housing. I am saying move. Move of how much? I'm saying move it of minus 10 mm, and it will move minus 10 mm, then it will be inside it. Okay, that you can see it from here. So like this, I want the two housing. So whether I should go and make the another housing, or I can do something else. I can select this here. I can press the control. I can move it here. Okay, then I will press the space bar. Already I know this is of 800 mm of length, and so I am going to put it around the 500 mm. So you can say by using this move tool, we can just move the whole component like this. So what are the good things are here? We learn, we have moved, we know how to use these tools. Okay, so like this it will be supported. So first thing here, I am not putting it here in this drawing. The bearings here, I have to put the bearing here at the both the cases, and I have to put the one screw here. Okay, I have to put the one screw here, that you should be aware. Okay, the screw can be okay. What I can do, to show you it. Is it visible? Okay, the screw will be visible here. Okay, now the screw will be visible to you here. So like this is there. Okay, friend, this is a lecture 6. Thank you.